What is up, everyone? This is Ruben. I'm here to tell you everything about WordPress hosting. What it is, how to pick the right one, the whole shebang. And today I have a special guest that was super interested in learning more about this topic. Welcome, everyone, my alter ego, Steve. What's up, man?
Here's your coffee.
Take a seat. So yeah, I wanted to learn more about this WordPress hosting you keep talking about. So I guess the first question would be, what is WordPress hosting?
Okay, so think about it this way. Basically, your website is a bunch of code and bunch of data that is sent to your visitors' browsers to be parsed. And your hosting is where that data and code is stored, basically like a home for your website. So your hosting provider is like a butler and a landlord at the same time?
Of course I do. Why do you ask?
So you partner with your hosting provider to get that storage space for your website and additional services that will help your visitors to have access to it. Actually, you know what? A butler would be more like managed hosting, because technically you can manage your website without that whole area of services that hosting providers nowadays offer. And let's say automated hosting would be more like having a smart home system, but more on that later. And then you have WordPress hosting plans, which are just plans that are specifically tailored to WordPress, which is the most popular CMS in the world that powers a good big chunk of the internet.
Okay, gotcha. And what are the differences, if any, between WordPress hosting and general web hosting?
Okay, so the main difference between WordPress hosting and general web hosting is that WordPress hosting's configs and resources are better optimized for this specific platform. This means that your server resources will be better allocated and your website will be pre-configured for easily adding things. This will definitely give your website an edge when it comes to speed and functionality, plus you will get better security because your hosting provider will focus on WordPress-specific threats and protect you better.
Okay, and next question. What are some of the features that your WordPress hosting should have?
Actually, this is a very crucial question because a whole lot about your website depends on your hosting provider. And if you ever run into any issues, your hosting provider is the single authority you will have to contact to solve those issues. And actually, you know what? I would need some more space to show the visuals here. So yeah, if you don't mind, could you?
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Sorry about that.
Yeah.
Now let's briefly go over the essential features here. And the first feature is speed. Speed is super important for site visitors. And what is important for user experience is also important for Google's algorithm.
You'll never be able to achieve a fast website if your hosting provider sucks. Hosting infrastructure is the number one thing that can make or break your website speed.
The next point is security. Lots of hosting providers do offer their clients automatic backups, security checks, free SSL certificates, and firewalls. So do make sure that your hosting provider does its part in protecting your website via network monitoring and malware detection and removal.
The third most important feature here is the ease of management. Your WordPress hosting provider needs to facilitate site management for you as much as possible. So if you ever need to scale your business and add new websites, you can manage them more or less smoothly.
The next feature to look for is compatibility. Your hosting should be compatible with all the additional features, software, and services you're going to be using. So definitely check out some reviews before committing to a hosting provider to make sure that other users don't run into similar issues. Then there's caching, the process of saving your website's data the first time the visitor opens your website, so the next time they open your website, it loads faster. No need for additional caching plugins here. Most hosting providers do include caching services in their plans, so all you need to do is activate them. You should also be looking for a hosting provider that auto-installs newer versions of WordPress, because after all, it's the 21st century, and why bother updating WordPress manually? And last but not least, make sure to pick a host that has stellar customer support. I can't stress this enough. Your customer support people will be like your guardian angels whenever you run into an issue with your website. And it's best if they're available via live chat 24/7. Look, you can't make the right decision about your WordPress hosting without knowing all of its different types. And the classical four types of hosting are shared, managed, dedicated, and VPS hosting. But there's also this brand new disruptive hosting type that you haven't probably heard of yet. That's automated hosting. Now, the cheapest and quite frankly the worst type of hosting you can get for your website is shared hosting. Shared hosting is basically like a big noisy commune.
No!
There's never enough space to share between large numbers of websites, so your neighbors will always make your website crash or make it vulnerable to hacker attacks. Plus, shared hosting will almost always make your website slower, which is frustrating and never helps anyone. Essentially, the world has evolved past shared hosting, so you definitely can do much better at the same low price point. Then there's managed hosting. It's that hosting type with the butler, where configuring and maintaining your server, guaranteeing high uptime and security, as well as providing reliable customer support, is all on the host. And this option can definitely save you lots of time and effort, but it also means that you're giving away lots of control over your server infrastructure. Now let's talk more about the disruptive newcomer. Automated hosting is like managed hosting, but it automates everything, even what a customer would usually do. Migrating, building, hosting, speed optimizing, and managing a website. It's basically like a butler feeding you a panna cotta with a spoon. What used to take days and months now is a click away. Let's go over the five pillars of automated hosting, and particularly Tenweb's automated WordPress platform, in more detail. Number one pillar is automated migration. While most providers will charge a fee and take at least 24 hours to migrate your website, Tenweb will migrate your website automatically and for free. Even if you're migrating from a different CMS, your site will be up and running on WordPress in just a click. Secondly, we have automated hosting. Tenweb's hosting on Google Cloud is equipped with all of the features we discussed in the video previously. You get everything taken care of, from security and automatic backups to high speed and caching. Automated hosting will get you a 99.90% uptime and lightning fast website automatically. Also, thanks to elastic scaling, your site will automatically access more resources if needed. Number three is automated page speed optimization. Imagine instead of spending months optimizing your website to please your visitors and boost your conversions, you obtain 90% page speed score automatically. This is excellent for SEO and will really help your website grow. No need to configure caching or install optimization plugins. Just enable it, and it's fast. Disable it, slow. You get the gist. And lastly, your host also provides a beautiful dashboard with which you can automate almost all processes that come with having a website. Image optimization, security checks, backups, analytics, updates of plugins, and WordPress. Everything you can think of can be managed automatically from one place. Next up is the luxurious and expensive option of dedicated hosting, where you get a full physical server for yourself. Dedicated hosting means a lot of freedom, but also a lot of responsibility, because you are the one to take care of all the technicalities of your server, which can be problematic for a lot of inexperienced users. And the final hosting type is VPS, Virtual Private Server. This is like a middle ground between dedicated and shared hosting, where you get your own space within shared architecture. And while VPS hosting is better than shared hosting, you still need to know how to configure, maintain, and secure your server, which can be a bummer for a lot of non-tech people. That's it, people. I hope you liked learning more about WordPress hosting, its types, and the innovations in the field. And did you like it, Steve?
Oh yeah, sure, I did. Now I know better, and I can make an educated choice whenever I need to choose a hosting provider. And you give this guy a like, a sub, and a comment for more updates on what you can do to grow your online agency. Toodles!
This video was brought to you by Tenweb, an automated WordPress platform designed for agencies. Automate hosting, speed optimization, migration, site building and management, and skyrocket your agency growth. Sign up for a 14-day free trial and experience true automation.